MGA, it's been a blast this year. 2015 has been an amazing season. I really enjoy working with you guys. Let's take a look back at all the things that have gone on this season. It's pretty crazy, it's pretty fun, and I hope you enjoy it.
You're analyzing your partner today. How would you sum it up?
He's great. Carrying the team.
Yeah, Billy.
Give me what you saw there. Your partner holding his weight?
Oh, he's doing, yeah, he's holding his weight. Oh, wow.
You weren't real sure what was going on with your wife.
That's true, and I said, huh? I don't think I want. He's doing wonderful.
It's his first way.
Hey.
It's his first way.
And my wife up there is doing really good, too.
Yeah?
You got to zoom on that?
Have you figured her out yet?
Yeah. I really have, believe it or not. I mean, it's 50 years this year, so if I don't have her figured out by now, I'm in deep kimchi.
So you're one of the original members here. Tell me how it's changed. For the better or for the worse?
Well, you have to look at it. The competition is a lot better. We started with 20 guys and it wasn't a lot of competition, but we had a lot of fun. You know, now you got 150 or 60 to play, so the competition's better.
My gang is here.
We've got the captain of this whole ship here, it looks like, Mr. Sharp. How are you playing today?
Off and on.
Off and on.
Had some good holes.
Well, how do you play something like this? This ain't fair.
Tell me about what happened with this shot.
Oh.
That's very nice.
At least we got it on you.
So tell me, how did we end up down there?
How did we end up down there? Well, how was that?
It's my partner's problem.
Yeah, it's my fault.
It's your fault?
Mm-hmm. Well, I was talking about
it. What would you tell him to do to get out of that situation?
Him? Throw it. Take a drop.
That's just brilliant.
Utter brilliance. How could a man of your superhuman power do that?
Cheat.
That's the one.
How do you feel being a bacon saver?
Oh, you said it's in my contract.
Do you like bacon?
That's what, bacon. That's what he was hired for.
Good shot.
You hold one out from how far?
It was about 130.
Yep.
Yeah.
Pretty close.
Yeah.
So your scorecard is going to show you got a hole in one on number 9.
Really?
You might be the first person to ever get a hole in one on number 9.
Meet the Blow Brothers. That's us.
Down like this,
yeah, but we parred the hole, George. We parred the hole. An ace is a hole
apart. Part of his nature.
So we're going to have to call pace of play on you?
Oh. All right, we're leaving.
How do you feel sitting in turtle fur?
Turtle fur, huh?
Right.
I don't know about turtle fur. That was on last week's...
That was, but you're getting to experience it this week.
Turtle fur, huh? Well, any kind of fur is good with me.
Has it improved your golf game?
No. Nothing helps my golf game.
I'm so excited. I've got my first death threat out here on the MGA.
Issues playing.
Oh, man.
After threatening to kill me.
No. I'm so sorry.
So the word on the street is we've had way too much Ron Sharp in these videos. What do you guys think?
I see him all the time. I'm tired of it.
Well, I would tend to agree. You only take so much of that country boy, and we've seen quite a bit.
Do you think it's the hat? Because, you know, ironically, Mr. James has a very similar one on over there.
I would be wearing.
Are you aspiring to be Ron?
No. His trade name is not so.
I have no idea. Well,
as our president, that's okay. You know, it's okay if he shows up one or two. You should get him though when he hits a bad shot.
Yeah. Then when he goes,
and he hardly ever does that, so it's kind of hard to get him when he hits one.
So far we got 8 holes. We're only 7 birdies.
That's it.
Yeah. Want to get the pretty guys?
I tell you what. So the word on the street here is that there's been way too much Ron Sharp in the videos each MGA week. What do you think?
Well, that's because I get paid the big bucks. You know, I should be. The big buck getter gets the attention.
That's true. And we actually have to pay you to feature you, I think.
That's true. But that's okay because I got a friend with a lot of money.
Perfect.
Bill has peaked.
Oh, I like the optimism.
My golf game peaks after my third Bloody Mary.
In 2 years.
1972.
In 2 years. See, I like that because you have the optimistic perspective. Most people are going back many years. Yeah. What do you think is going to be the catalyst in the next 2 years for you?
Move up to the greens.
Why don't you ask Rick when his golf game peaks? I'm not sure when mine does.
So yours is still going up?
No. When I've had a good Bloody Mary.
It's still coming.
Tomorrow.
I like it. Is that perpetually renewing each day?
Okay, because that's when it is going to get better. It's tomorrow. Yeah.
I like it. I love the optimism because some people have went with like 40 years ago. Like this guy over here.
We're hoping.
Keep me out of that. I got nothing to do with this one today.
When I was in high school.
That was a couple of years ago, right?
Yeah, it was. It was. Just a few.
We got to check your license to see if you can even be allowed to live here.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
Say my golf game peaked May of last year when I shot my age, shooting 65 at age 66.
That's pretty impressive.
Peaks when?
Yes.
Peaks when? It peaks after 6 beers.
Years ago. How's that? How are you feeling coming off of your weekend championship?
I'm doing great.
Feeling
great, feeling lucky. You know, life it couldn't be better.
Extra cocky?
No. Nah, definitely not. Found my game, we'll put it that way.
All right.
If I tell you, I'll put the jinx on me.
Yeah?
I don't want to do that.
I think the addition of the beard might have really helped you.
I shot a 44 in the front. John's killing.
Unbelievable.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
What was your hand?
It's awesome.
Oh, $100 a ticket.
$100 a ticket?
Yeah.
So I gotta get a sign off to say you can
beat the judge. Well, there's four of us, so you know we'll make a package deal of $240.
See, you know,
I had a question for you, but you understand the area that you're living in. Nobody can remember what they were thinking to ask, and so I've forgotten what it is I wanted to ask you.
That's a combination of sitting in turtle fur.
Yeah, I'm going to tell other people and see if they can help me remember. He's useless.
I'm useless.
I'll say.
He often doesn't tell me what's on his mind, so it makes it more difficult.
Look at that.
I got it. Yeah. I see it on the green. That wasn't bad at all.
No.
It's like he's been on camera a few times.
That's unfortunately that's the truth.
Is that
that's
the deal? Do people need Nike shoes like that?
Nike shoes.
Is that that's nice. The ticket.
Nice cleats on the bottom.
They'll play better if they have those shoes.
That's correct.
Just talking that they decided to put the four best looking guys in the same group today, so we're having a wonderful time telling each other how handsome we are, and I'm the only one that's poor. The rest of them have a lot of money.
Does your does your game look as good as you do?
Oh yeah, well I'll tell you what, we're just having such a good time, it just couldn't be any more fun.
Couldn't be any more
Maybe
fun.
Maybe a couple less double bogeys and it would make it more fun.
Have you avoided the five putt today?
Oh, you know, I have.
The last time I saw you, you five putted.
Right. Not even any four putts, so a few more three putts than I would like.
It's on the up and up.
Thank you.
Did it well, Don.
And a stay down with a thick grass.
Yeah.
Those ASIC shoes are doing it for you, huh?
I hope I'm not in your flight.
Are those legal?
My shoes?
Yeah.
Well, I guess we're not.
My granddaughter's picked them out.
That definitely sounds illegal.
It'd be crazy. It's more like what mine would say, especially putting. You ain't gonna hurt me. Hit it.
You probably can't print it.
They say they're safe with me because I'm not hitting them.
You dumbass.
Not the first time I've heard that today.
That was your best shot?
That's it. That's a good question. I'd not even thought of that. My golf ball would probably say, would you please put on some glasses so we know where we're going?
Take a pickleball.
Hit me harder.
You can't say that on camera.
Larry's calling his shot here like Babe Ruth that this putt's going to go in, ladies and gentlemen, so we're going to record it.
Amazing! He caught it!